a priceless treasure. God knows me, God. Welcome back to day three. Today we're learning that God comforts you. You are treasured. When we're sad or scared, God helps us feel better. God can even cheer us up. Can you think of a time when you have been scared or worried? I want you to take a second pause here, and I want you to share with each other or share with people in your family a time when you've been scared or worried. We'll see you in a second. When you felt this way, maybe you hugged a family member or snuggled with a stuffed animal or even cuddled with a blanket. I even like to play with a fidget when I feel this way. We all have experiences of times where we need comfort. Maybe you are scared of a thunderstorm and a huge storm rolls through your neighborhood. Maybe you've been bullied at school or had someone spread lies about you. God doesn't promise to take away the problems that we experience, but He does promise to be with us, holding us through each and every one of those problems. Today, we are going to make a stress ball that looks something like this to remind us that God comforts us.
You are treasured!
All right, before beginning today's craft, you wanted to watch the Getting Ready for Today's Craft video. In that video, you'll learn how to make your water beads full size. It takes about 1.5 to 2 hours to do that. So if you have not done that step, go ahead and stop the video and get that step started. If you have, you're ready to get started with today's craft. So for today's craft, you're going to pull the rest of the things out of your day three bag. You'll have an empty bottle. You'll have a balloon. You obviously have your water beads, and then you'll also want a paper towel and about 1/4 cup or so of water as well. So go ahead and gather those materials and then we will get started with our craft. Hopefully you had fun filling your water bottle with your water beads. Now we're gonna actually make our sensory balls, again, that look like this. So what we're gonna do next is you're just gonna take your water, and I have about 1/4 cup. I'm not gonna use all of it. I'm just gonna fill just so that the very, very bottom has a little bit of water. And the reason for doing this is just so that the, there we go. So just a little bit of water, you'll see right here at the bottom. Just so that the water beads stay moist, it'll make your sensory ball last just a little bit longer. So once I've done that, this next step, you definitely are gonna need someone to help you. It could be an older sibling or a parent. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna blow up this water balloon and then have somebody else hold it for you. And you've got to, while it's blown up, get this over the top. And so it is tricky. You wanna make sure that you get a really good seal so that you don't get water or water beads leaking out of it when you pour it in. So let's go ahead and do this next step. Stretch my balloon a little bit, blow it up. All right, then I'm gonna try to open it up here as best I can. And I'm gonna place this on here and try to get a nice strong seal. There we go, just like that. And you'll know if you try to get the balloon all the way down underneath the lip of the water bottle, then you'll be set to go. And then this is the really cool part. Here we go. You tip it over and listen to it as you pour in all of your sensory beads. You might have to shake it a little bit. There we go, and the water until they get to the very bottom. Isn't that cool, Isabel?
Yeah.
Really cool. And then you're gonna very carefully take this off and the air is gonna come out and that is gonna be okay. You try to let the air out slowly if you can. So I'm gonna grab onto it because I'm gonna have to tie this off. And again, you might need an adult help to help you tie your balloon here. I'm gonna shrink it down. There we go, and you want to let out most of the air. You want to leave a little teeny bit at the top here so you have an area to tie it. You don't want to let it out so much that the water beads start coming up to the neck of the balloon here. So I'm just going to stop it right there, and then I'm going to go ahead and tie it off or have an adult or older sibling help you tie your sensory balloon. And then you have a really fun sensory balloon to play with. And I'm sure you're going to really enjoy playing with that at home. And when you're playing with your stress ball and enjoy squeezing it and playing with it, I want you to remember that God is there to comfort you.
You are treasured!
He's always there for you and to bring you comfort when you need it.